Hi everyone. Today we're going to be talking about how artificial intelligence can be used to track the next pandemic. Artificial intelligence, also known as AI, is defined by the Oxford Dictionary as the development of computer systems able to perform tasks that normally require human intelligence, such as visual perception, speech recognition, decision-making, and translation between languages. To simplify, AI is a computer program that is capable of performing a task which requires intelligence. This task is usually something a human can accomplish, such as learning, planning, and problem solving. Artificial intelligence uses machine learning to give computers the ability to learn without explicitly being programmed. Machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence. It employs algorithms that learn from data to make predictions or decisions that allow performance to improve when exposed to more data over time. An algorithm is a set of instructions for solving a problem or accomplishing a task. Machine learning starts with data, such as numbers, photos, or text. This data is then gathered and is used to train the computer system. The more data, the better the AI model. From there, the computer system trains itself to find patterns, make predictions, and create algorithms. Deep learning is a subset of machine learning and closely mimics the way a human brain works. It uses many layers of neural networks to create algorithms that find the best way to perform tasks on its own. It analyzes data similarly to the way a person would look at a problem. Deep learning allows the computer program to improve its own training techniques to learn complex patterns in large amounts of data. When the computer program is given data, it decides for itself what features are relevant. There are many applications of AI within the field of healthcare and medicine. Primarily, AI has been successful in the tracking of several diseases, including COVID-19, Zika virus, and Ebola. AI can do this by using machine learning to scour the internet, news sources, flight mapping data, plant and animal data, social media platforms, genome databases, and various other health data to track and predict the progression of these diseases and viruses. For instance, companies can look at data from health forums where individuals might discuss an unusual onset of symptoms. From this, AI can track when, where, and how these diseases are progressing. For example, in 2011, researchers found that AI was able to accurately estimate the H1N1 outbreak through tracking specific keywords on Twitter alone. However, this type of data is called unstructured, which means it is really difficult for computers to decode this data. Structured data is more quantitative in nature and includes numbers and reported cases, which are easier to track. AI today uses more complex algorithms that involve deep learning to be able to look at this unstructured data. AI companies today also use natural language processing to track data in different languages. But for these AI models, researchers must train it using data for the algorithm to be able to run on its own. Therefore, the effectiveness of the AI to be able to accurately track and predict disease progression and outbreaks depends on the quality and the quantity of data used to train the AI model. There are many examples of AI companies that focus on disease tracking. Some examples include HealthMap, which tracks social media news articles, Metabiota, which combines biological, political, socioeconomic, and environmental data to predict disease outbreaks, and Blue Dot, which tracks flight data. In this video, we will focus on Blue Dot due to its relevance as a Canadian-based company that has gained a lot of popularity since the COVID-19 pandemic. This Toronto-based digital health company was founded by an infectious disease physician named Dr. Kamran Khan in 2013. The software works by using an algorithm that can detect 150 different pathogens from data sources that include news reports, medical bulletins, climate data, livestock reports, and human population data. These searches are performed every 15 minutes, 24 hours a day. When any irregularities are detected during these searches, the algorithm then tracks airline ticket sales from over 4,000 airports across the world in order to predict how the disease may spread. At this time, the computer alerts the user, and then epidemiologists and public health workers look at the data to verify the results. Using this method, Blue Dot was able to detect the presence of unusual pneumonia cases in Wuhan 9 days prior to being detected by the World Health Organization, which was later known to be COVID-19. The software was further able to predict 12 out of 20 of the next cities to get hit with COVID-19 cases based on airline ticket details. COVID-19 was not the only time that Blue Dot has been proven as a successful tracking tool. The outbreak of the Ebola virus and the spread of the Zika virus were also predicted by Blue Dot. The future implications of Blue Dot are vast when it comes to handling infectious disease outbreaks. Using Blue Dot, scientists can detect outbreaks as early as possible, understand how diseases are dispersed to different parts of the world, determine the consequences of the spread of diseases, and help protect populations, empower public health, and coordinate emergency response. It is apparent that Blue Dot offers numerous benefits. However, it is important to address the limitations as well. These include the ethical issues associated with accessing personal data. Another limitation occurs when biased or inaccurate data is used, which could affect results. And lastly, inaccurate predictions may lead to mass hysteria if released to the public. Despite the limitations, Blue Dot and other AI companies will play an integral role in future epidemic and pandemic tracking, which in result will help save countless lives.